हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ श्वेता पाटिल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, सी के ठाकुर कॉलेज, न्यू पनवेल, ऑटोनॉमस. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक इंट्रोडक्शन टू द डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स. सो लेट्स सी, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द टॉपिक डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, लेट अस डिस्कस व्हाट इज मीन बाय द डेटा एंड द इन्फॉर्मेशन. एज यू नो, डेटा इज नथिंग बट व्हाट? Collection of the raw material, and this raw material is in the unstructurized manner. Okay, so what is the example of the data structure? Data, that is a name of the student. The individual name is known as a data. Again, roll number of the student is again the example of the data, and phone number of the student, which we are calling it as a data. Now, what is mean by the information? Information is nothing but what? Collection of the data is relatively known as the information. So, what will be the example of the information? The detail of the employee, which contain the example of the information. Okay? In the next, what is the actual definition of the data structure? So, data structure is a combined word, that is a data and the structure. So, as you know, data is nothing but what? It is a raw material. That raw material, when we are going to process, when we are going to organize, and when we are going to structure, that we are calling it as a data structure. So, it is a way of designing the data in the memory, so that memory we can use in the future. Okay, so that memory contain the information in the unstructurized manner to the structurized manner. Okay, as you can see the examples, there are the some examples of the data structure are arrays, linked list, stack, queues, tree and the graph. Okay, in the next they have given the classification of the data structure. So, classification of the data structure is categorized in the three types. First is the linear and the non-linear type of the data structure. So, what is mean by linear and the non-linear? When the elements we are going to form in the sequence is known as the linear. For example, example is array. Okay. So, array is what? Array is a linear. And what is nothing but a non-linear kind of the data structure? When the elements which do not form any sequence, this is known as the non-linear kind of the data structure. Okay, so this is about the type number one. In the second type, homogeneous and the non-homogeneous kind of the data structure. Homo, the word homo indicates this is the similar kind of the data. So, when you are forming the similar kind of the data, then this is called as a homogeneous. And the example for the homogeneous is what? Array. Why? Because array only contain the similar kind of the data. If you process the integer as well as character together, this is not an array. Why? Because array only contain the similar kind of the data. Second is a non-homogeneous kind of the data. So, what is thing non-homogeneous? It is a opposite to the homogeneous. Okay. So, non-homogeneous is nothing but what? Different kind of the data is known as non-homogeneous. Okay. So, the example for the non-homogeneous is a linked list. Okay. So, linked list we will discuss in the types of the data structure. Okay. So, the third type of the classification, that is static and the dynamic data structure. So, what do you think by the static data structure? The static data structure are those whose memory occupation is fixed. We can't change any item in the static. We can't do any alteration in the static. Okay. So, static nothing but what? It is a fix. We can't change anything. Okay, and the example for the static is again the array. Okay, students, array is what? Array is having the declaration of the similar kind, that is the integers, or either you can use character. You can't use same at the same time. Okay, so what is mean by the dynamic data structure? A dynamic data structure are those whose memory occupation is not fixed. So whenever you are processing any data and that data memory allocation is not fixed, okay? So that not fixed type of the data comes under the dynamic, okay? And the example for the dynamic is what? Linked list, okay? In the next, so these are the types of the data structure. As you can see in the diagram, students, data structure are broadly categorized into the linear and the non-linear kind of the data structure, okay? In case of the linear, there are the four types: array, stack, queue, and the linked list. And under the non-linear kind of the data structure, they have given the two types as a graph and the tree. So let's discuss this all the types one by one. First type of the data structure is the array, okay? So what is the definition of the array? Array is a collection of the homogeneous kind of the data. Homogeneous is nothing but what, student? Similar kind of the data. When you are processing the similar kind of the data, that is the array. As you can see in the given diagram, that is array contain the 6 element. How many elements? 6 element. And array's indexing always started with the 0. At a 0 index, you can see the element 23 is present. At the first index, the element 1 is present. Second index, the element 6 is present. Third index, the element 15 is present, and so on. So what is the basic rule of the array? Array contain only the similar kind of the data, and that the indexing always started with the 0. Suppose you have the 7 element of the array. So what is the indexing will be starting from the 0 to 6, okay? And under the types of the array, there are the four types: one dimensional, two dimensional, three dimensional, and the multidimensional, okay? So this is all about the array. So let's discuss the second type, that is a linked list, okay? Now, what is mean by the linked list? Linked list is a collection of the nodes that contain the two parts. That two part is nothing but what? The first part is the information and the second part is the address. Okay? What is? The first part is the information and the second part is the address. So, as you can see in the diagram, the linked list contain how many nodes? Four nodes are there. First node is A, second is B, third is C, and the last one is D. So this first part we are calling it as information. What is mean by information? You have to put the data, you have to put the numbers, you have to put the characters, okay? And the second part contain the address of the next node. So whatever the next node is there, that address we are going to store in the previous node. So B's address part contain the address of the next node. C's address part contain the address of the next node. And D's address part contain the value as a null. Why null? Because after D, there are any nodes are present? No. So because of this, last node address is always written as a null. Okay. So this is about the linked list. Now, in the third type, they have given as a stack. So what is nothing but the stack? Stack is a collection of the node that will follow the principle LIFO. LIFO. That is last in, first out. So whoever come last, that we are going to remove first. For example, dinner plates. Okay. Whenever you are arranging dinner plates on the table, so first dinner plate you are putting, then second, then third, then fourth. So whatever the fourth dinner plate is there, you are going to take first. Okay. Third dinner plate, secondly. So whatever the last is there, that will be removed first. As you can see in this diagram, the stack of 5 element, first element I have inserted as a 5. Okay. Second element I have inserted as a 6. third element I have inserted as a 9 and the last element I have inserted as a 2. So 2 is my top of the stack, and this top of the stack is contain the operation push and the pop. What is mean by push? Whenever you are inserting any element, this is known as a push, and whenever you are deleting any element, that is known as a pop. Okay, so push nothing but what? Insertion, and the pop nothing but what, student? Deletion. Okay, so this is a representation of the stack. Next, we are going to see the fourth type of the data structure, that is a queue. Queue is again the collection of the element that contain the principle first in, first out. Okay, what is first in, first out? Railway ticket counter example is there. So whenever you are going to the railway ticket counter, if you are in the queue and on the first position, you will get the ticket first. If you are on the last position, you will get the ticket last. Okay, as you can see in the diagram, there are 0 to 5, that is 6 element are present in the queue. Okay, so at a 0 position, element 7 is inserted, then first index, element 2, and so on. Okay, so in the queue there are the two operation, front and the rear. So what is nothing but the front, students? Front is nothing but what? Deletion of the item is known as a front end, and insertion of the item is known as the rear end. We are inserting the element from the rear end and we are deleting the item from the front end. Okay, so this is about the queue. In the fifth type, that is a tree. Tree is nothing but what, student? This is the hierarchical representation of the parent and the child relationship. Okay, so whenever parent and child is there, tree comes out. As you can see in the diagram, A is your parent and the below nodes are your children. Okay, so that is about the tree. And the last type, that is a graph. Graph is again the collection of the node that contain the vertices and the edges. So these all circle will represent what? Vertices. And this line will indicate what? Edges. Okay, so this line is nothing but what? Distance between any two node, we are calling it as a edge, or we are calling it as a path. Okay, so students, this is all about the today, and we have discussed the topic introduction to the data structure, its classification and its type. Okay, thank you everyone.